And I like to always start off by thinking about how things work in one dimension. Right? We've all got a pretty good feel for one-dimensional stuff now. Right? So changing coordinates in one dimension. Right? We're sort of reparameterizing the line somehow. And it looks something like this, right? We've got f of g of x. Right? So if we've got an integral of this form, we can change coordinates in the following way, right? So we switch to the coordinate system u is g of x. That affects the change for us. Right, so that's what happens if we've got a single variable change. And I think it's important to pay attention to what this guy is doing. This guy is, this g prime is measuring sort of the amount of stretch between d of x and d of u, right? They're sort of measuring how much bigger is du and dx. Sort of recalibrating your measuring stick or something. So that's the one variable theory. Now we're going to talk about how this works in multiple variables. So this is a similar kind of thing. So we're switching from x's and y's to u's and v's, and we have to figure out how exactly things are going to change when we make this change of variable. Okay, so we'll look at the two regions to begin with. So in the x-y coordinate system, our y's go from 0 to 2. And our x's go from 0 to 3. So this is our region of integration in the xy version of things. And then in the uv coordinate system, we get here. Square region. Okay, so we've seen a linear transformation that takes these guys to these guys. We've got about that x is 3 times u minus 2 times v. Right, so if we want to go from this side of the picture over, we've got a linear map that does so for us. So now we want to try and come up with some formula that will calculate this for us. So we're going to do a little bit of guess and check here. So we're going to guess what to do and then see how to amend our guess to make it work. First guess is that we're just going to plug in u and v for x and y. Hopefully that works. Able to make a change as follows. We just plug in the things. This is the unmodified guess. Okay, so we'll try that out. And we want to check, did that agree with the original thing that we had? Right? Does that actually agree with this fellow here? I think people give guess and check a hard time. It doesn't seem like right enough or like truthy enough. But this is the only way people ever figured this out. It's just by trying one side and checking with the other side. Okay, so let's check. Does that really match the thing that we had? So this will become Right, so we get 9 plus 6. That's 15. Okay, so we are pretty far off. Right, the two things do not quite match. Sad. So the guess of switch coordinates naively by just plugging things in didn't quite work out. Right? That would be analogous. The following idea in single variable calc. Right? If in single variable calc we had the following rule, if we're able to change variables directly without having this G prime in place, that would be analogous to what we did here. Right? This is the directly plug-in version of things. Okay. So what we're missing is the piece of the puzzle that relates dx dy to du dv. Right, we're missing this g prime here. Right, we need a higher dimensional analog of this g prime. Okay, so there is a relationship among these two things. If we look at these two answers, they differ by a very interesting factor. They differ by a factor of 6. What is that factor of 6 really doing? This factor of 6 is related the linear map between these two objects. Right? If we start off with something of area 1 over here, its area gets distorted up to 6 over here. Missing in our calculation is the factor that measures area distortion. Same kind of calculation, but we'll take into account that distortion of area.